Welcome back to our course on Project 2013. In this section, I'm going to do a quick run through of what's new in Project 2013. Even if you haven't used Project before, I think you're going to find this section useful because it will introduce you to some of the key points that we'll be covering in the course. The best source of information for what's new in Project 2013 from a fairly non-technical point of view is within the Office section on Microsoft.com, and there's a page there called What's New in Project 2013, and I want to go through the main points on that page in this section. One of the sections on that page is headed Get Started Quickly, and this really describes the main features of the start screen in Project 2013, the screen we saw earlier. And from this screen you get links not only to creating a new blank project, but you can get links to project templates that we're going to look at later on, and then various other links to facilities to import information from Microsoft Excel or from SharePoint. We'll be looking at the start screen in more detail later on. One of the main areas of extension and improvement in Project 2013 is in the range of reports that are available. There are some new and greatly improved graphical reports, and there are also new types of reports such as burndown reports. You can also use Lync 2010 or later to communicate with members of your team by instant message, video chat, email, or even a phone call. If you're dealing with a complex project and you're having trouble sorting out some issues with a specific task or around the area of a specific task, you can look at the task path for the selected task, which shows all of the predecessor tasks and all of the successor tasks, conveniently coloured to help to identify them. And then there are some other new or improved features here. The first of these, take projects into the far future, means that we can now schedule projects with project dates up to the middle of the 22nd century, which is probably far enough ahead for most of us. And then other new features include the sharing of meetings. If you export your project reports, timelines, or other project data into other Office programs, you can share those online on any supported device. You can save and share project files in the cloud, as with the other components of Office 2013. And if you use Project Online, you have access to a full version of Project from almost anywhere, and you can run it even on PCs that don't have Project 2013 installed. We'll be looking at most of these new features during the course, but in the meantime I suggest that you look at this page, What's New in Project 2013, and maybe follow some of the links on that page to describe some of the features in more detail. That's it for this section. I'll see you in the next one.
Hi everyone, Simon here from Simon Assessit. Thanks for watching this video. If this is your first time here, I'd love for you to subscribe. Every Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, new videos are uploaded to the Simon Assessit channel here on YouTube. Just click on the subscribe button right over there. If you're interested in taking your Microsoft Project 2013 training to the next level, you can get 19 hours of Project 2013 training offered by Simon Assessit. Just check out the About section below this video with more details. We'll see you next week with additional videos.